A stone's throw from the bustling city lies an idyllic water paradise. Hidden within a lush sea of green. Scenic freshwater forests, small streams, and majestic lakes, bringing life to the trees, flowers, and creatures. A king stalks this domain, but an uprising threatens his rule. A kooky Romeo looking for love. And an underwater menace wages war. Welcome to the garden's wild world of wetlands and lakes. The Keppel Discovery Wetlands, tucked away in the Singapore Botanic Gardens' southwest corner. A 1.8-hectare habitat of freshwater forest wetlands. Carefully restored over the years into a flourishing ecosystem. Malayan water monitor lizard. A long, powerful tail makes for easy gliding through the water. Too hard for breakfast. These seem just right. It's been spotted. Maybe better luck at lunch. At the north end of the gardens, the scenic, tranquil Eco Lake, where you'll find this busy creature with a fresh sashimi lunch. White-breasted waterhen. Often found in shallow waters, foraging for aquatic animals and flowers along the shore. A sharp beak helps pick out seeds from unopened buds. Off to the next one. The Singapore Botanic Gardens team is checking on the water's pH level. Today's reading comes back to alkaline. So they're adding dead terminalia leaves to help acidify the water. The perfect pH means the perfect habitat conducive for native aquatic life. That draws nature to the wetlands. Like the kingfishers. From August to March, the gardens are teeming with these migratory visitors who bring a riot of color. The stork-billed kingfisher, the white-throated kingfisher, the collared kingfisher, and the smallest of them all, the size of a small ruler, the common kingfisher. Always perched on a low branch near shallow water, scanning for prey. Target acquired. And almost 90 degrees of salt into the water at a speed of 40 kilometers per hour. Lucky this time. One strike to kill its prey before swallowing it whole. Tucked away from the public, a delicate operation is underway. A brood of orphaned lesser whistling ducklings rescued from Changi Airport. A mugshot. Tagged, then bagged. Ready to be transported. Their new home, a shady nook of the Eco Lake. Meanwhile, at the west corner of the Eco Lake, a female white-breasted waterhen has caught someone's eye. Love at first sight. Just like in the movies, every love story begins with a little stalking. Now, Romeo needs to show off his foraging skills. That's how you impress a lady. Bright and early in the Singapore Botanic Gardens. Yoga on the lawn. And yoga by the Eco Lake. Morning stretches. And morning, business. The white-breasted waterhen, engrossed in a delicious seed. Oblivious to a possible predator. Looks like the Malayan water monitor lizard won't be getting lunch either. It's also caught the attention of the bravest of birds, the Javan miner. Just because you're big doesn't mean you're boss. Checking in on the 5-month-old orphans. room service. But they're not interested. Plant matter at the lake's bottom is more enticing. Tipping their bodies upside down in a move called dabbling, not dabbing. A chilly morning in the wetlands. As the sun warms the gardens, the animals get to work. Waterhen lovebirds are inseparable. The male has got something on his mind. That was quick, but it gets the job done. The Malaysian pied fantail. Distinguished by the fanning movement of its tail. Looks cute, but it's a deadly hunter. Also called murai gila, meaning crazy thrush. Its frenetic hunting style startles insects in the air, catching them mid-flight. All this to feed two hungry mouths. In a teacup-shaped nest made of twigs and grass woven with spider web silk. Time for an afternoon nap after a food coma. To the south of the gardens, in the wetlands. The female white-breasted waterhen is seeking higher ground for once. Away from the danger below. Away from the hubbub of urban life. The Singapore Botanic Gardens has a surprise. It's the season of new life. Baby fever. While the younger waterhens are playing, older ones are already in training. Picking up life skills. Over time, their plumage will mature into gray and white. Legs will eventually turn yellow. But these black cotton balls are in no rush to grow up. At the Eco Lake, the lesser whistling ducks have adapted well to their roomy outdoor home. All grown up, the orphans are ready for the next phase in life. Their world is about to get a lot bigger. The ducks suspect something's up. Life beyond bars for the first time. No one wants to be first. Maybe just a little nudge. One bravely ventures into the unknown. But the other is desperate to get back in. It's been separated from its bonded partner. For now, it needs to find shelter first. Monsoon rain, filling the garden's veins with fresh water. Every drop has a huge impact on the landscape. Nature's way of replenishing the wetlands and lakes. The cycle of life continues. The next morning at Eco Lake's Duck Manor, And then there were six. Plus one. The bonded duck hasn't left all night. From its sentry post above its partner, shooing off pesky passers-by. Man trying to find a way to break back in. On the other side of the eco lake, the fisherman bird makes an appearance. The striated heron with its characteristic striped wings is one of the smaller herons at only 40 centimeters tall. What it lacks in stature, it makes up for in patience. It can stay in this crouched position for up to 40 minutes. ...90% of fishing is waiting. Waiting. And more waiting. Lunchtime at Duck Manor. The bonded duck still refuses to leave its partner. So it gets a takeaway on the roof. Hungry, as it hasn't left its post in days. Back to sentry duty. The monsoon rain stirs up nutrients in the waterbed, triggering an explosion of growth. Hydrilla, an invasive aquatic plant, can choke the oxygen supply of fish. So the Singapore Botanic Gardens team trawls for hours, removing boatloads of green. As always, upcycling is in. Laid over where rain has washed off leaf litter, feeding essential nutrients back into the soil. Meanwhile, back at the eco lake, The juvenile white-breasted waterhen. Looks are important now. Gone is the fluff ball. Its feathers have become smooth. And its tail vent has turned red. Striking out on its own. A week later, time for the next release. The sentry lesser whistling duck is nowhere to be seen. But its partner is being freed today. Her frantic calls beckon. And her bonded partner hears them. Reunited at last. Now to shoo off the third wheel. As the mid-year heat gives way to cooler months, the garden's bird population starts to grow. Residents are joined by visitors. Migratory birds escaping south for winter. Including the yellow bittern. Found in reed beds, along the banks of the Eco Lake, feeding on insects. A female with brown streaks on its body. And a male, distinguished by its black crown. This skillful bittern has a knack for hunting. tree roots as stilts. And a master of the Van Damme split. No stiff neck there. A strong core for sure. A failed ambush. Too slow. It's Freedom Day for the last four lesser whistling ducks. The welcome party are ready. A joyous reunion that soon turns into sibling squabbling. These pecking, not peeking, ducks are vying for alpha position. With the hierarchy re-established, peace returns to the kingdom once more. But not for long. The red-eared slider. Unhappy about sharing its territory with these newcomers, a villain in a half shell. A tag team effort. Persistence pays off. In the garden's plant center, the team loads up seedlings and young trees that have been cultivated in the nursery. The precious cargo requires the utmost TLC. Their destination? The wetlands. Planted on the banks to minimize erosion from the rain, and to provide more places for the animals to perch, hide, and nest. A flourishing environment that will also make for a beautiful view. at the heart of the gardens, the Symphony Lake. The white-breasted waterhen, now an adult. Insect eggs and larvae make for a tasty treat. Looks like it's found a partner, too. A romantic afternoon together. The lesser whistling ducks have been roaming free for 2 months. They've mastered the traffic rules. Who has the right of way? And even what to avoid. Becoming seasoned residents of the gardens. The bonded duck pair have been inseparable since their release. Venturing out in twos. Hopefully, a new brood of lesser whistling ducklings will soon follow. It takes a nation to maintain this island's secret utopia, protecting one of the last remaining forests, nature's refuge, and its lush freshwater habitats, bursting with life. At times, we may disregard these amazing animals that live in plain sight. Just look a little closer and discover a community of exceptional wonders, making a home in this garden in the city.